You're listening to Property Source Radio 222-6397 live from High Falls, Rochester, New York. If you're looking for open houses this weekend, PropertySourceRadio.com. Click on WNY Open House to see this weekend's opens. Don't forget to add PropertySourceRadio.com to your favorites. It's a great way to check out our home front, ask questions, and suggest ideas for topics you'd like to hear us cover. Pat and I are live in the studio this morning. We've been joined by Tayshia Palmer and Katie Levin, and they're from the Teschner's Decorating Center, 2815 Monroe Avenue, right here in Rochester, New York. We want to thank you, Katie, for joining us today. We're going to bring in Scott McCurdy and learn to paint like a pro in this last segment. So thank you so much for joining us, and welcome, Scott. Thank you for
having me. Good morning, Brenna.
Thanks so much for joining us this morning. One of the things that Teschner's carries that I've been hearing about from Cousin Patrick for a year or so, maybe a couple of years now, is a paint called C2. Every time Pat talks about painting, it's all the C2 paint, the C2 paint. So we're going to learn in this last segment about C2 paint.
And who's going to answer the question, Scott or Tayshia? C2. I want to tell you, first of all,
whoever knows the answer, because it sure ain't me.
Okay.
However,
yes,
I did take note that in this studio, the drapes match the carpet.
Awesome. I got the hardwoods installed. I'm okay. I have C2 paint in my house and outside of my the whole exterior was done last year. Scott McCurdy did it for me last year, and he did the inside of the house, and almost all the rooms in the house have the C2 paint. I love the stuff. It's tremendous to work with. I really didn't work with it much, but I watched.
It turned out good, right?
It turned out beautiful. The colors are beautiful. The swatches, I love the swatches. They're, what are they, poster-size swatches? What do they call those? What size are those? Swatch? They're big.
It's a poster-size sample. It's don't know the exact
poster
dimensions.
Yeah.
It's very, very large.
You ever had a poster of Lonnie Anderson on your wall when you were a kid? It's about that size, okay? At any rate, the colors are, it's real paint on these poster swatches, so you don't get fooled. You get tricked in those other stores.
All right. Save time and money with the ultimate paint chip. Our gigantic 18 by 24 inch C2 chip, folks, on TeschnersDecorating.com. Do your homework, Patrick.
That's too fun.
So those are big ones.
Yes. Now, Tell us how is that stuff? I mean, I know it's, I'm gonna talk about the price right now, because it's a little on the high end. It's a premium paint. We'd call that a premium or a high end paint. It's about $48 retail a gallon. Now everybody that's listening may say, oh my God, that's expensive. Why would you say that's not really expensive?
For a couple of reasons. One, because you use less paint when you use C2.
Yep.
And two, because it's not more expensive than the higher end paints at some of the stores that have huge marketing budgets that I'm not going to mention, who they put the money that you pay for your paint into those commercials and into all of that wonderful marketing that they do, instead of into the gallon of paint. When you purchase a gallon of C2 paint, you're purchasing a paint that has the most titanium dioxide content of any other paint in North America. Why does that matter? Because the titanium dioxide has three functions. One, it makes your paint more durable so that it lasts a lot longer. It's not going to fade. You're going to be able to wash it, and it's going to look more beautiful. One of the things that the titanium dioxide does, it holds the pigments, the color pigments, and it makes them, there's no way to describe it really other than more luminous, more radiant. Anybody who has C2 paint in their home, once they've painted with C2, usually they stay with C2 because there's a different quality in the environment of the room that's kind of undescribable until you've actually seen it and experienced it.
Mm-hmm. I concur. Actually, I've seen it, and it is beautiful. I really know that for a fact.
I will attest to that too, Pat. The paint, I'm sure it had something to do with the professional application, Scott, that painted in Pat's living room and in your foyer area, right?
And the powder room and
the dining
room.
And absolutely
the
beautiful.
Hallways
the colors are gorgeous, and they do look very rich. They just have a rich look to them, so they're very beautiful. When you're painting, Scott, my question is prepping the wall as important as the paint you choose?
Definitely. If you really want to get a quality paint job on the wall, you need to make sure you first prep the wall properly to accept the paint, and also to repair any blemishes on the wall, too, that will show up. They'll still continue to show up even with a coat of paint.
What about toothpaste? Can you use that?
That's not a good thing.
Just kidding. I saw that once in a magazine. I thought to myself, who would put toothpaste on there to fill in a nail hole? You know, just get some spackle, right? How about sheen? When you're choosing a sheen for the room, I've always gotten a lot of questions about that and always wondered about that myself.
Well, that's kind of more of a decorating type answer than it is for me. But sheen would depend on what room you're painting and also what kind of lighting you're getting in the room too. You don't want to go with something with a higher sheen in a room that has a lot of windows, a lot of natural light coming in, because you're going to get a lot of reflection back off of the walls. Something a little softer towards a flatter and eggshell finish would be better for that.
But that makes sense.
Maybe.
Now, Scott,
Katie can attest to that question better.
Good. Thank you. I have a quick one. What type of paint, what brand of paint do you like to use?
C2 paint.
And why is that?
It is for the same reasons that Tayshia gave. It is a far superior paint than else is available out there. But from a user standpoint, it's a very, very nice paint to work with.
That's what
goes on nicely, covers well. You know, one thing that I like about the paint is I can dip my paintbrush down in there, wipe the edge of it off. I can stand there and have a conversation with a homeowner for 5 minutes waving my brush around.
He's done that
before.
The
paint stays on the brush until I want it to come off the brush.
Yeah, it makes me nervous.
Other paints, you dip the brush in there before you can even get it on the wall, it's dribbling all over the place. So
okay.
From a user standpoint, it's a lot nicer to work with.
Interesting. Mm-hmm.